don't you ruffle my feathers neither. You said I'm crazy, I'm wild.
Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. You're tuned in to LA Talk Live, where we're working.
It's big pimping, baby. It's big pimping, spinning.
What's up, everybody? Now, that song is a proper introduction because I'm big pimping today because you're my co-host.
I know. I'm so excited. I can't believe it. It was a total surprise to me.
Well, this is what happened, and it worked out perfectly, of course, in my favor. Like, the stars aligned, and I love Romi, but Romi, you're out. Just so everyone knows, Romi and I did not break up. Our relationship is as solid as it can possibly be, but she had a really horrible allergic reaction. And the worst part, they don't even know what it is. She might have eaten something or something's in her system.
Oh,
so,
no.
You know, she had to go to the doctor. She had to get, you know, injections and all that good stuff. But she broke out in hives, poor thing. She's trying to truck through all that, but she's having a really hard time.
That's intense.
Yeah.
Oh, my
So she's
God.
She's been a little ill. So if everyone could tweet at her, send her some love.
Oh.
You know, she's going to be okay, but she's, you know, not feeling too well.
Oh,
so
poor thing.
I came up with the most amazing idea since you were our guest last week and we had some technical difficulties. I was thinking, co-host.
There we go. So I'm excited to be here.
I'm back again. I'm glad you decided to do it with us. So we have 300,000 people, over 300,000 people listening to us. And we have no technical glitches today. So we are live, on air, rocking it out. Everyone can see the beautiful Yvette Yates. Yay!
Yes.
And everyone
Make sure I came out all glammed out, you know?
You look beautiful. I look a little, I don't know, out. Just out.
No,
glammed out. I'm just out. I had kind of a rough night last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I kind of partied a little bit too much.
Was it on your Twitter account?
Yeah.
I should have checked it out.
If you check out my Twitter, that's how you know what's going on in my life. You know what time I go to sleep and what time I wake up because I'm constantly on it. And I just recently signed up to IG.
What's IG?
Instagram.
Oh, my God. I'm barely trying to get... I think I have like 9 photos or something.
My friends finally attacked me last week and said, you know what? We're tired of adding at Rose Needs an Instagram.
Oh my God, are you
And they finally grabbed my phone. They made an Instagram for me. And now it's like, now I'm addicted. I love it.
Nice. How many photos do you have already?
I only have about maybe 12.
Wow. In how many days?
In like, I would say, I have over 1,000 followers, but I have only 12 photos that I posted up. I try to post like 3 a day.
Nice.
So it's only been like 4 days. But the one thing I've noticed about Instagram is... Twitter's different because it's a constant conversation.
It is. I know.
And I
just barely got used to that right now.
But you can say what you're doing if you're at the gym, if you're doing this, if you're doing that. It's okay to constantly post. On Instagram, it's like you can't say anything without putting a picture.
Yeah.
And then you have to talk about the picture.
And then go have a conversation about that. And I'm like, and Facebook is totally different.
It's
like
kind of
it's
a combination
different animals
of both.
And it's, yeah.
But the one thing I don't like about Instagram is people post a lot of unnecessary things. Like, hey, I'm in traffic. Look at what I'm eating. Look at the picture of my shirt. Like,
but people follow it. They love it.
I don't like it. That's the only thing I don't like. So you know what? I try to become creative with things because I'm not creative with anything in life unless it's social media. So the one thing I did was it's all about the hashtags, like what you hashtag. So now I'll put like Instagram sucks.
You
know, this is so boring. I hashtag everything.
Oh, my God.
I hashtag everything like that's ridiculous with whatever I post on there. And you know how they have Throwback Thursday?
Yes.
So people were doing, to me, Throwback Thursday means like at least 2 or 3 years ago or longer or when you were a kid or back in the day.
Yeah.
And they'll Throwback Thursday like 3 weeks ago.
Oh, yeah. No, they do. I mean, it's just like every sec, everything. It's insane.
So what I did was I took photos that day and I was like, Throwback Thursday, 3 hours ago.
Nice.
People thought it was silly and funny, but I'm trying to have fun with Instagram and it's so difficult because it's just not. Like, I can't get into it yet, so I'm trying.
Yeah, no, I'm in the same boat. So, out there, please, you know, help us out.
But you need to get one.
I know, I do. I just...
You need to get one.
I do, like, one picture, like, every few
weeks. See, but for you, it's different because you're out there in the public eye. For example, I would have Instagrammed your outfit and been like, this is what I'm wearing today by, you know, yada, yada.
Yeah.
And, you know, this is... And
by RZA.
There you go.
There we
see? Because you have a beautiful outfit. But, I mean, for me, it's more like I took a picture of my dog in his bow tie collar. Like, what am I going to do?
What's his name or her name?
Rocco. Yeah, he's really cute. You would love them. You would love them. But last week we had some technical glitches, so we're going to talk about your movies, your up-and-coming projects. I'm going to do, after our break, an Yvette Yates exclusive interview.
I love it. I'm ready for that.
I'm going to grill you and ask you a few questions.
All right.
But we're going to get into some, you know, current pop culture, and we have a few things to talk about. Mm. So I'm going to let you start it off.
Okay, well, actually, Chris Brown and Rihanna, you hear about that? That they broke up?
I'm tired of hearing about them.
I seriously thought I just heard that they were back on.
They were just back on.
Like, literally, like, maybe like back Thursday ago.
I think.
Like, you know, something like that.
Exactly. Last throwback Thursday, they were together. Yeah. I don't understand their dynamic. I mean, obviously, they have a very toxic, you know, kind of
intense, yeah,
you know, relationship. What it's driven by, I have no idea. But he recently went on Power 106 and a couple of other media outlets.
Yeah, I heard him on 102 with Secret.
Yeah, and he straight up, you know, went out and said that he's no longer with her anymore. And she started Instagramming photos of herself at a strip club.
What?
And then took them down.
Really? Because the one I heard, like, seriously, like, a few days ago was that Secrets was asking him about marriage and
what was he
down the line. He's like, yeah, I could see it down the line, just not right now. There's too many people who count on me. That's how he put it.
But was he talking about Rihanna specifically or
in
general?
Well, he asked him, and then he's like, okay, what about, you know, just in general? Do you see that as, you know, part of your life? He's like, yeah, but not right now. So that's why I'm like,
But they're both young. I mean, they're both, like, you know, in their early 20s. They're both mega stars. I mean, they're huge. Mm-hmm. She's, you know, world renowned and, like, you know, on that Beyonce level. And he's on, I don't know, Lindsay Lohan's level. No, okay. I just don't like the guy. But either way,
they'll collaborate on something and they'll
get back together.
Yeah.
I mean, they should, in my opinion, I'm no one to say who should be with each other or not. But I just think that with the whole violence thing and the way they got back together this last time,
it doesn't really mesh.
I was at a Laker game and they were sitting across the court from me. And it was on Christmas Day. And I went with some friends on Christmas Day. They got me, this is a gift, some very, very good friends. Aww. And they were across the way. And they were literally, like, she was feeding him popcorn. He was, like, caressing her back.
It's just so hard, I think, with the media on you. I don't know if it's just, you know.
And that's something we're going to talk about. I'm going to grill you on that with public and private relationships. Because when you're a media, you know, when you're out there in the media and you're a celebrity. I mean, I am a Twitter celebrity. And my relationships are...
You're supposed to laugh at me.
You can laugh at me. It's fine. That's the whole point. No. But it's true. Like, whoever I date, it's really weird. Like, there's if I make a comment, let's say I make a comment to you.
Yeah.
Right. And we're friends. And, you know, obviously she's into guys and I'm into women and we're totally just friends. But if I were to say, that's nice what you're wearing, people are going to be like, oh, my God, they're dating and da 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 da.
They turn it into something else.
They do that. They do that to me. Like, if there's a girl or anybody that I even say hi to, these little people, like, get all nuts. And they start either attacking that person or they start saying, you could do better.
Oh, my God.
One or the other. I have no idea. It just depends on the mood.
Depends on the picture.
But I deal with a very minuscule level of Twitter phenomenon and lesbian fame.
No, but you're going to see it start affecting things and just how people respond.
It does affect the people that I date. Like, I'm dating this one girl right now. Who's, like, across the country.
Oh,
and, like,
wow.
Even she, like, kind of trips sometimes off of the media. Not the media, but the Twitter people.
Just because of what they're posting. Because
they're now following her. And they're now making comments to her.
Oh.
And if I'm, like, out and take a picture with someone, they'll, like, send her the picture and say she's now with her. And, like, just weird stuff.
Are you serious?
And it's hard not to get mad and want to defend. But, you know, I just kind of let it roll off. But I could imagine, for me, it's, like, only 18,000 people. I could imagine someone like Bieber, who's 35 million.
That's, yeah.
Or someone.
Or just constantly. Just in the media.
I mean, just constantly in the media, and they're just being, you know, spotlight on them the whole time.
Wow.
No, I can go to Pasadena or Highland Park.
That's kind of nice, though, just to be able to kind of weave in and out and do your thing.
But in my world, since it's predominantly revolves around my lifestyle, it's hard.
But see, it's like because it is so much of what we are and our brand and, you know.
And that's the whole thing. Like, I have to be
people.
In that world. Right.
Yeah.
And it kind of affects you. Speaking of branding
and
speaking of connecting with my favorite person, Kim Kardashian.
You know, I actually, I like them as a family because they're just so.
I do.
They're so close. And I actually, that's the part I do respect.
You can see that they love each other.
Yeah. And they all like, you know, they're all making money, but they're all helping each other make money.
Right.
So they're keeping it in the family.
I think the mom is like the godfather. She like represented and took, you know. I think she's going to start breeding even the grandchildren to be branded.
Oh, already. I'm sure with like a clothesline. I mean, a toy line. I'm not surprised.
But
not
in
like
Kim Kardashian's defense, I mean, I got to give her props. She did make something out of nothing.
She did.
And I mean, there's this, you know, those memes on online.
No, what is that?
You know what a meme is?
No.
I'm learning all this stuff. I'm so not, you know, tech savvy. But a meme is, you know, the grumpy cat.
Yes.
That's a meme. Like it's a picture. And they put the comment on there, right?
Oh, yeah.
So I saw this meme of Kim Kardashian and Ray J from their sex tape.
Wow.
And it says, started from the bottom. Now my whole team's here and the whole family.
Oh.
And I was like, how mean, but it's so true.
It is kind of true. You know, but they don't even hide it. I mean.
That's what I love. They own it. They don't care.
They do. They really do. They're like, yeah, okay, whatever.
They're like, this is what we did. But you know what? We made something out of it. And it is what it is.
And people are buying it. They're not forcing anyone to get it. So.
I mean, they've become this huge empire just based on people supply and demand.
Exactly.
That's what it comes down to. But Kim is in the news because of her fashion faux pas.
Oh, yeah, because she's wearing heels and she looks fat. Yeah.
But here's the thing. You're more way more fashionable than I am, so I'm going to let you handle this. But what do you think in regards to she's a public figure?
Yeah.
So you always have to look good.
You do.
I mean, you know what I mean? And she's a brand, like you just stated. But she's pregnant. She's not fat.
No, she's like, not. I think, you know what? I think it's, you know, they were saying that back in the day, like, it was all about hiding the bump. And it's like, you know, she's a woman. She's gorgeous. She's voluptuous. And
right.
I think we kind of have to celebrate that. You know?
I agree. I mean, I think she looks beautiful pregnant.
I agree.
I think that because she is such a fashion maven and she's, you know, dating a guy who's Louis Vuitton ambassador and a big fashion maven as well. Or is a maven a man? Or how do you say it? Fashion raven? I don't know. But they're both really well known in the community. And he's very well respected in Paris and all New York and all the fashion outlets. And he's very well known and celebrated for what he wears. So for me, I can't see her in a muumuu.
No.
Come on. Or in sweats.
I mean, we've been seeing the show for how many years now? And she has her, she has her clothesline too. And she's talking about her heels and everything. That's what she feels comfortable in.
But I mean, as a pregnant woman, how do you, not now that you're pregnant, but as a woman, because I would never be a pregnant woman.
But you were talking about having kids last time.
But I want
here.
The girl I'm with to have the kids. Or I want to just adopt them. I can't.
With how nice.
I can't physically birth a child. No.
No?
No, I don't have time for that.
Time or too scared?
Either one. I saw my sister deliver my niece.
Really?
My brother-in-law and my sister. My sister came to my family's house. It's a great story. Latin families, you know how we are.
Yes.
We're celebrating a cousin's birthday. My sister's like, I need to be there. It's my cousin Danny's birthday. Her due date was like a week later, week, you know, from when she was coming to visit. They live in Palmdale, which is far.
Yeah.
And it's like 45 minutes an hour away. So she's like, I'm going to spend the night at grandma's house and we're going to celebrate, you know, my cousin's birthday. Yeah. So earlier in the day, she felt sick and she told my mom, I need to go to the hospital. I think I'm feeling contractions. It's second child. My mom takes her to the hospital. 5 hours later, false labor, you're fine. 3 a.m, we all spent the night because it was my cousin's birthday.
In Palmdale.
In LA, she lived in Palmdale. So they're like, she woke me up. I need to go to the hospital. I'm like, dude, you had a false labor. You're fine. It's probably because you ate too much. nothing's happening. It's 3 a.m. Get out of here. She's like, no. My mucus plug came out. I know what that means. I'm like ready to go. And I'm like, go where? Take me to the hospital now.
Oh,
and I'm like,
my God.
Okay, my niece is now, you know, 16. So this was back in the day when it wasn't like cell phone savvy. I mean, I had one, but I was like calling her husband.
This was a while ago. Yeah.
Yeah. I was calling her husband. It's 3 a.m. He wasn't picking up the phone. And I'm like, her husband's not picking up the phone. What am I going to do? So I'm like, I gotta just handle this and you know,
and take her.
I wake up my mom. She's like, go to the hospital. It's a false labor. Don't worry about it. I'm like, everyone's leaving me alone with her and the mucus plug. Like, it's just me and the mucus plug. And I got to go take care of this. So I need a doctor, right? Drive to Kaiser Hospital on Sunset. Admit her. And I'm like calling everyone. Like, you guys, what's up?
And no one's there with you?
They're like, when she's getting ready to have the baby, just call us. Apparently, labor takes hours, right? That's what everyone assumes. Not in this case. The doctor goes, you're XYZ centimeters dilated. We don't even have time to put, you know, anesthesia in you.
Oh,
this baby's coming now. They gave me scrubs, told me to go change, and told me to go into the delivery room.
Oh, my God.
I wanted to cry. Okay? I am like...
You weren't even there for the first one. This was the second.
The second one. And then I'm like... And the second one, I don't even want to change his pamper or look at it. Nothing. I'm not down with babies. Not down. So then I'm like, okay, let me do this. I just got to suck it up. My poor sister's crying. She's throwing up. Okay? I'm dealing with all this because they're like... It's pregnancy, no big deal. They see this day in and day out.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking it's like the end of the world. I'm holding a throw up bucket. She's throwing up everywhere. I want to cry, but I'm trying to be strong for her because I'm like that trooper.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, the doctor comes in, hands ready to go.
Sanitizing.
About to ready to get, you know, grab the baby. She grabs me and she grabs me from my shirt and she says, make sure my baby's okay. Go look. And I'm like, what? If you ever get married, don't do that to your husband. Just letting you know.
Were you just lying?
Just let him hold your hand and support you from the top part of everything.
From this part.
Until the baby comes out. So then I go to the front because my sister asked me to. I see the baby's head full of hair.
Crowning.
Coming out of her area, which is an area that I'm very fond of. Not hers, up to my sister, but just in general. And it like changed my whole perception at the age of 22 of what pregnancy is all about and birth.
And that just kind of...
It changed it.
Closed the deal.
Then to
you.
Make matters worse, the baby comes out, which was a beautiful experience. Don't get me wrong. Like, I was the first person besides a doctor to touch her. Aww. And it was like, oh my God, like this baby came into this world. You were just nothing a minute ago, you know? It's crazy.
Nothing a minute ago.
You know, like it wasn't even here. But then the umbilical cord came out, like it was there.
Híjole.
And it looks like Rubbermaid, like ribbed. It's weird. It wasn't like I imagined it in my mind.
Yeah.
It was just strange. They gave me this weird pair of scissors and she's like, cut the cord. She's like screaming at me and like everyone's looking at me like all this pressure. So I just cut it. It bleeds. It's weird, dude. I was like, this is not what
that
I thought it was.
That was intense. Oh my God.
I just relived it all right now on national worldwide radio.
Well, so you know, maybe you kind of brought a message to someone else who's
Have kids. Think about it. It hurts. She was in pain the whole 45 minutes.
45? That's not even bad. Like
45
the
minutes.
Stories you hear.
She would in 45 minutes. I endured with vomiting, her screaming at me, stuff coming out of stuff, and to make matters worse, the baby part wasn't even the worst part. Are you ready for this?
Oh my God.
They have plastic on the floor. Right? They tell me to stand back. And I'm like, the baby's in like a little McDonald's warming. Looks like a French fry is being warmed up. All crying.
A hot pocket.
Yeah. I'm like, my little baby's no clothes on. Oh, man. Like, I'm like freaking out. Then they tell us to step back and move. And the placenta afterbirth comes out. And it's like, it looked like aliens. Like, yeah. Not the business. So Kim Kardashian, if you're listening, good luck, girl.
She's having twins, no?
Is she?
Yeah. I thought she was having twins.
I have not heard. She's big enough to look like she's having twins.
Yeah, I think
if
so.
If she doesn't have twins, she's just fat.
Yeah.
You just ruined it for everybody.
I think she is having twins.
I need to Google and see if she's having twins.
Yes, I think
really?
So. Really? Yeah, because didn't she do the whole thing like in vitro or, you know, so I think that usually.
Did she do in vitro?
I think so. Yeah,
I thought it was natural that he just happened to accident.
No, I think that's what I
really?
Heard.
Really? I have to start looking this stuff up.
You have to.
I have to start looking this up. Okay, so now that we're talking about body image.
Yes.
And obviously you're an actress and you're out there in, you know, in that industry.
Yeah.
Christina Aguilera just recently lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, she did.
And she looks beautiful. But for me, like body image, like how do you feel about the pressures of like the industry that you're in and the body image and all that stuff? Like how does it, like how much pressure is it as an actor to be out there and to have to fulfill that visual expectation?
Well, I think, part of me, like, I've always been, like, a gymaholic. So, I'm at the gym every day, and
I
love it. And it's
hate
I'm
it.
One of those, like, morning people. I'm like, okay, let's go. And
you really like that?
I love it.
How?
It just gets me going. Like I don't know,
like, if we were, like, close friends, and you were to be like, Rose, let's go to the gym at 6 a.m., I'd be like, you're crazy.
No,
I'm like, I'll meet you for breakfast at 9 after.
I don't know why. It just, like, starts my day.
I mean, I admire
it. I've been
it.
Doing it for, like, since I was in high school. So, I think that's just kind of what it is.
When I was... When I was in high school, I was an athlete.
See, I wasn't.
I know. I was like softball, basketball. So I have natural muscle tone. You can touch it if you want. But
nice.
I'm like all about like constantly, like I was all about sports and that's what kept me active. And I was like the bomb in high school, like six pack, all ripped. Like girls, you would have died.
You're like,
but then I met something called alcohol. And then that just changed my life and slowed me down.
And made it harder.
And made it harder.
But since you
do you drink?
I do drink. I like my occasional, but you know what? When I'm working, like, I have this kind of rule where I don't drink. I don't have my cupcakes, my sweets.
So you're real strict.
I'm really strict.
So here's the difference between you and I. It's called one word. Discipline. Andale. You're disciplined. You're disciplined and you're driven. Two words. I'm just like, hey, I'm here to take it as you want it. But I mean, it takes a lot of, you know, commitment and discipline to do that.
Because you're like, okay, I have to look a certain way. You do have to, you know, obviously, like, depending on the kind of role that you feel you fit. So it just varies.
And I mean, Christina got to a point where she was just like, screw it, I'm gonna let it all hang out. And she did. And she did gain weight and was not the typical dirty Christina that we saw in the dirty videos and with the abs and the whole nine.
But she went to an extreme, I think, that, you know, could be borderline maybe unhealthy. I'm not saying that it's not like she didn't still look beautiful, but I'm saying like for...
She wasn't taking care of herself.
There's a certain line where you and cross and she's it's about business. You, your health, yeah.
And I mean, as actors and singers and people in the public eye, I mean, you're your own business. Your body, what you put out there. True. Whether it's acting in your craft or singing in your music, I mean, that's part of your package.
Exactly.
So you have to be responsible and hit the gym.
Yeah, I mean...
That's a lesson I'm learning.
But, I mean, I think it's not fair to also, you know, judge someone just because... I mean, and that's the hard part. You see people, oh, they gained 5 pounds or they gained 10 pounds.
Well, I mean, look at Jennifer Hudson, too. She was... Yeah. She made it and won an Oscar being what they considered... I thought she looked beautiful either way. But then she went on Weight Watchers and lost a tremendous amount of weight. And now she's being, you know, getting so many roles.
So many more. But you know what? They asked her to actually they actually offered her the Precious role, what I had read about.
Really?
She turned it down. And then I think they were doing reshoots for the Dreamgirls. And then they asked her to gain weight again. She was like, no, I'm not going to do it. But I think it had to do more about her
own personal stuff.
Yeah, her own personal stuff. It's how she felt. I think it's how one feels. And I think that's... Ultimately,
has a lot
the
to
most
do with
important
it.
Thing.
Yeah. Well, I feel good not going to the gym, and you feel good going to the gym. So there's.
I do.
We're gonna take a quick break, and when we come back, I'm gonna grill you and ask you some questions have our whole audience get to know you, know what you're doing, where you've been, where you're coming from, and where you're going.
Awesome.
So we'll be right back, the Romi and Rose Show with our special guest Yvette Yates. We'll be right back, everyone.
See you guys. With my drink and my two-step, my drink and my two-step. Your glasses in a row, you start to think I was Q-tip. Bartender pour around, I took a few sips. Stumbling, falling down, I ain't drunk, that's my new step. Now why would I listen to bullshit they shovel? When they taste level ain't at my waist level. I'm fly, get on a plane, jet lagged already. I'm tired, the go-yard bags is heavy. I'm fire, the flow hard as a Chevy. I told her me like E, she said she like me, huh? But when she see me with a CL like P-Rock, she just wanna grab the microphone and beatbox. Even in high school, I was always a special kid. First pack of condoms, I asked for extra big. Now I got a flow that sit me right next to big. And all these old rappers don't know where the exit is. But bubba, no buts, nigga. What, nigga?
Cinema.
Inspired motherfucker, Donald Trump, nigga.
Mardi Gras.
Killing these niggas, can't front, nigga. Now let's drink to that till he drunk.
Oh, you know I love to show off, but you never thought that I would take it this far. What do you
I got
know?
These niggas breezy. Don't worry about it.
Light. What do you know?
Thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.
Mountain Valley Spring Water, since 1871, has been bottled at the source in Hot Springs, Arkansas. Twice named the best tasting water in the world, Mountain Valley Water is naturally alkaline and bottled in glass, providing the perfect blend of nature's minerals, giving you a crisp, clean taste. To start your home and office delivery in Southern California, call us at 1-800-499-9982 or visit us online at www.mountainvalleywaterla.com. New customers will receive their first 2 5-gallon bottles free. Mountain Valley Water, the official sponsor of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane on LA Talk Live.
Yeah. It's your boy DJ Deezy inviting you to join me every Monday night at 8 p.m. for our new show, Keeping It Real with His Cousin, exclusively on LA Talk Live, Monday nights at 8. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio or watch us on Ustream TV Monday nights at 8. Reality Radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
you suffer from degenerative diseases such as
high blood pressure,
diabetes,
fibroid tumors,
high cholesterol,
genital herpes,
or a plethora of other diseases that rob you of a quality life.
If so, then visit the website of herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra
at dhealthstore.com
and open the door to natural healing at an affordable price.
dhealthstore.com has over 1,800 products created by herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra,
specifically designed to help you heal the natural and safe way.
At dhealthstore.com, you'll find everything from herbal formulas and cleanses, such as Tahuti's famous Full Body Detox,
as well as
herbal teas,
extracts,
natural body butters,
lotions,
creams,
children's products,
hair care products,
and of course, sexual enhancement products for both men and women.
So visit the website of Tahuti Ma'atra, dhealthstore.com, or call toll-free at 1-888-823-9416. dhealthstore.com.
Yeah, Inglewood in the house. I see you, Tommy. Let's get it.
Yes, blackin' like Brown Division crackin'. Mild temper, motherfucker, but smoke stay actin'. Ask Jim Malone now, what niggas stay poppin'. I'm a S of that for y'all. I'm contrasting smoke knockin' in the streets, making ends. Got grams, so I'm baggin'. Graduated from the wood, so your trash was hadin'. It's time to get this cheddar, D gang, do it better. 45, stay ready, haters flee like spaghetti. Lights off, flames on, and off, been red. Brown D and R, so the pockets get heavy. $20 to the homies, you can die for something petty. Guatemala with machete, crushing niggas like a Betty. Palm trees, Cali trees, THC to the brain. Keep it 1,000, live and stay in your lane. This dope right here, shit is death to your brain. And I'm the one you heard about, walk away with your chain. Yeah.
Bitch,
DK. Brown Division, drastic measures, Oh no, back again, Inglewood's fresh, it's Mexican, on the rise, on the come up, on the grind, till the sun up, win a prize, if you run up, slinging pies in the sun.
We are back, everyone, thank you for tuning in. I want people to give us a call. We have Yvette Yates here, the beautiful actress, and my co-host today, replacing Romi for our wonderful hour of mayhem.
Just for today. We'll have her back.
323-247-7443, everyone out there. Give us your calls, your questions. We have some giveaways. We have a bunch of good stuff. But before I do all that, I do want to ask you a few questions.
Okay.
Let me get my notes out here. Okay. So you were on the show last week, and we did a mini interview, but we didn't get a chance to really get into it because we had some technical difficulties. But you're back today, and we have hundreds of thousands of people listening and watching. We want to know about you. Bottom line, where you're from, where you're going, and where we can find you.
Nice. Well, you know, originally I'm from El Paso, Texas. See that Juarez, Chihuahua. So
hey!
Border town girl.
Mexico! To all our Mexicans out there.
Yeah. And all our Latino peeps. Yeah, no, I'm just really, I love what I'm doing. And, you know, that I'm able to use this platform as an actress to give our people, like, just another side, not just a stereotypical role.
Right.
And with the thick accents, which is fine, you know. I have relatives, my parents, you know, there's definitely the people.
What's wrong with thick accents? I have one.
Which is great. And it's sexy. But, you know,
she just said sexy. Shh, everyone, just saying. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
But it is nice to show them, hey, you know, there is another, you know, we can dominate two languages, three languages, you know, and not have accents.
I mean, there's a lot of,
be just as American.
A lot of positive, you know, Latino, like one of my favorites, Edward James Olmos.
Yeah.
He's always active and out there with the community and making sure that the Latinos, you know, do have representation. But coming from Juarez, and El Paso border, people don't realize how close that is. It's literally just like one little freeway.
Yeah, you just cross right over. And, you know, it's like the TJ San Diego thing. It just, you know, people live and work and one in the same. It's just,
and Juarez has gotten kind of a bad rap in the last few years because of all the drug cartels. And it was considered, I don't know if it was this year, but the number one capital of murder capital of the world.
Yeah, it was.
I mean,
the most dangerous.
It's crazy.
But you know what's crazier is that I think recently El Paso is deemed one of the safest cities.
Isn't that ironic? States, so
which
you
is
have
really insane, yeah.
And probably because there's such a huge, heavy presence of Border Patrol and all that good stuff. But I think Juarez gets, it's justifiable, but they do get a bad rap because there are people there that are good people trying to live their lives and
there
just
is, and
caught
it's getting
up in a business, you know, of the drug cartels that have nothing to do with. You know,
yeah,
the people that
and it sucks really because you I go to the mercado and I go to different places and you see how affected the economy is. But I think slowly and surely people are feeling like okay.
But do people still go and they still go and cross the border?
They're starting to now again.
Because like, things are getting calming down.
Yeah, everything's calming down. The businesses are reopening. There's a lot of
that's
American
good. That's good
businesses
to hear.
There. Yeah,
that's good to hear. And then again, coming from that community and coming from El Paso, I'm sure they're really proud of you and that they. But appreciate the fact that you're speaking very highly of where
of
you came from.
Of course, I'm very proud. They gave me El Paso gave me my own day.
She has her own
26th or
September 25th is your day
25th.
In El Paso.
Yeah, it is.
Wait, the city of El Paso gave you a day.
The mayor and the city council. Yeah, I was like,
that's a big deal.
Yeah, it was pretty exciting.
Nobody gave me a damn day.
Wait, where are you? Pasadena?
No, I'm from Highland Park.
Oh, Highland Park. Oh, but you live in.
Jeez, probably because I sold out and went to Pasadena.
Andale.
They didn't want to give me a day. They gave me a day to kick me out.
No.
The other thing that I love about you is that you're extremely educated. And what caught my attention is you're educated in physiological science.
There you go.
But you're an actor.
I am, yeah.
Like, how does that...
I just always wanted to do it. But, you know, education is so important in my family. My dad's, professor. My mom works with autistic children in El Paso. And, so education is just like from the day we were born, it was instilled. So I got my degree and then I was like, God, I just really have to act. And
but,
I don't know
I mean,
how. And
I would have gotten a degree in like, history or like liberal arts.
I just,
like you went
I
for something that's crazy. Like you really went to school to go to school.
I am
like I would have like I would have fugazied it and I would have been like, you know what, I really want to be an actor, but I'm just gonna get a degree just to get my parents
and
off
then,
my back. But you went like for something that that's crazy.
Yeah, no, I really did. I do love this. I did want to, that medical school was really something serious
so
that
you,
I was thinking about.
Really? So
yeah.
You were, that's crazy.
Yeah, and I published
way.
And I got and I did research for a few years in the school of medicine at UCLA
wow.
and. In the laboratories and then so but I always tell my parents I'll understand the verbiage when I get a role playing a doctor. I'll actually like know what's going on
and it'll be like a real life situation.
Exactly.
But that's like highly commendable. Okay, so
thank you.
You come from El Paso, borderline Juarez, then you go to UCLA and you knew you wanted to be an actor but you thought you'd overachieve and get this crazy science degree and possibly have the outlet of pursuing medical school. But now you are a successful actor.
Yeah, luckily I've been, working with films and, the last about 2-3 years have been just amazing, working with
What was
with
your
amazing.
First break?
The first break was actually a short film called Niña Quebrada, Broken Girl, and it was about human trafficking. So it was really
wow,
dark.
Wow, really?
Yeah, and I went to all these festivals and it just garnered so much attention and nominations and that just helped me, get my representation.
And was it in Spanish or English?
Both.
Oh, wow.
Both,
so it was,
yeah.
And you're fluent in both dialects and
Correct,
you know what's
yeah.
up.
Yeah. No, yeah. So wow. that was what was great about it. And so from there, I did shorts for about 2.5 years maybe. And then I got Without Men with Eva Longoria and Kate El Castillo.
I mean, that's a huge
and
stars
like,
in that movie.
Yeah. I mean, I got the call. I was walking with my brother and I was like, I don't want to yell on the microphone, but I was just like, ah!
So you went from shorts and then all of a sudden you get a call for your first film and it has Kate Del Castillo, which people don't know. She's probably one of the biggest soap stars. Like she's huge. She's a big Latin star. And then Eva Longoria, who we all know.
Yes.
I mean, that's insane. Like your first movie role is like with these huge stars.
It was surreal. And, someone's like, did you win the lottery? And I'm like, yes. I was just like,
And how were they with
something.
You as up and coming? They're already established Latina actors. And here you are up and coming, like were they mentoring? Were they nice?
They were really nice. Eva was a producer on the film. So I think that was really cool because it was about, it was a large female cast, Latina cast. Judy Reyes from Scrubs, Maria Conchita.
Wow.
And it was a comedy. And so for me, I was like, wow, she's, created this project and is supporting other Latina actors. Which
and it's
is,
all Latina women.
Yeah, which is, we had Christian Slater and Oscar Nunez, but it was primarily about the women and we were all in equal footing. And that was just... I thought, like, wow, we need more of that.
Wow.
So
it was more inspirational.
It was.
That's really good.
Yeah.
But your first role, you get this big break, right? So you have this short that got a lot of attention. You continue to do work. Then you get Without Men. And then what happens after Without Men?
Without Men. And then I get, when I'm at the premiere actually of Without Men, which I brought my family to, and I was excited.
Were they excited?
They were so
excited. They're like, she made it! She made it! And your dad's like, damn, I want her to be a doctor. No, I'm kidding.
She's like, you know, todavía puedes, you know, and I'm like, dad.
Your parents want you to be a doctor, or they accept you being an actor?
They accept it, but, you know, they're always like, you know, it's always there. I'm like, yeah, I know. I love them.
So you're on the red carpet, you're at the premiere.
Yeah, my manager's like, hey, you got the role of El Gringo, which is a Joel Silver film. You know,
and I saw that movie.
Yes, you did.
I saw El Gringo. We're gonna get into that after you tell me your experience, because I have a couple questions about that movie.
Yeah, no, and, it, you know, I got the call, and I play the female lead in that action film, and it's
you actually really kick ass in that movie. You're
Thanks.
Good. You look amazing. Gee,
what? It's very different from Without Men, so it was like so
but
much fun.
In that movie, now that we've talked earlier in the first segment about the gym, I could tell you go to the gym in that movie.
I don't know why you would say that.
You don't. You leave some to the imagination, but you do kind of like how comfortable do you feel?
I feel
like
really
playing a sexy lead.
You know, for me, I was like, this is my Selma Hayek moment.
Yeah.
You know, kind of a la
Desperado. It kind of reminded me of that. That's exactly what I was thinking when I watched the movie. It was very Desperado-ish. I mean, where it's like the hot lead dude who's a badass.
Yeah, Scott Adkins.
The hot lead girl who's a badass. And then you have this, like, I mean, the movie was shot beautifully. Like, I love the movie. It was shot gorgeous.
Yeah, the director, Eduardo Rodriguez, he was amazing. And, you know, just we shot in Louisiana, the interiors, and then everything outside is Bulgaria.
It looks like Mexico.
So the Mexicans are the gypsies from Bulgaria in the gypsy town.
Wait, you're kidding me.
No.
Those extras were Bulgarians?
Yes, they were all Bulgarian.
Brilliant. No, because it looked like, I mean, I've been to Mexico and all different parts of Mexico.
And it looks like
Mexico, straight up Mexico.
It's, yeah, that's what was kind of crazy. I mean, for me, I was like, why didn't we shoot in the border town? I'm from a border town.
Oh, so they wanted to protect you guys.
But, you know, but for me, I was like, great, when else am I going to go to Bulgaria? And I love just experiencing.
How long did
culture.
You guys shoot?
In Louisiana, we're there just a few weeks, and then Bulgaria, like a month and a half.
Wow.
Yeah, so I really got to, you know, I went to like the monasteries and these old villages, and I mean, when I go, I love just to really just go into the culture
and everything.
And
did you work out while you were there?
I did.
I'm kidding.
I did. They had a fantastic gym, actually. Okay. I was really excited about.
Well, here's the thing about this movie. Like, I watched this movie, and I loved it. I mean, it's nonstop action from the beginning to the end.
Thanks.
Number one, which I love, and it's you would think. El Gringo, like, what's this movie about? This movie really, to me, was all action, hot people. Christian Slater is in it, which
Christian
I love.
Christian Slater. It's my second time working with him. And
I love him in this movie. I mean, he has a small role, but, you know, you and Scott, his name Atkins?
Yeah.
You guys carry the film. Obviously, you guys are the stars of the movie. And the one thing I noticed is your chemistry between you guys was a little on the hot side. I mean, there's a couple scenes where I'm like, whoa. And there's one scene in particular where I was like, what? How comfortable did you feel like, you know, getting in the nitty gritty with him? I mean, he's a hot guy. Don't get me wrong.
He's in an insanely great shape. I mean, he's even stricter. I mean, I'd be like, hey, are you going to eat? And he's like, oh, you know, it's just be like steamed chicken and vegetables. Like, he was super strict on his diet.
Really?
Because he came from those Undisputed movies and the Expendables. So he's very just into the martial arts. That's how
right,
he
that's
came
his whole
into
thing. Because I mean, he kicks butt throughout the whole movie. Did you have to do any training for?
I didn't, but the scene, you know, where they're pulling me around and you know, it's towards the end.
I don't want to give it away.
Yeah, I don't want to say, but, and they're, you know, pulling me around. Like, I told the actor, I'm like, who plays Culebra, and he's Israel Islas.
He's
amazing.
He's a badass, that guy,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he's from Mexico City, actually.
I like
he's
him.
He's really cool, yeah. And I was like, and, you know, he was holding my hand. I was like, pull it for real. Like, I have to react to you. And then he's like, you know, I don't want to hurt you. I'm like,
but that's part of
it.
You having to be able to let that out.
Yeah, and then the next day, I had a chipote in my head.
Oh,
like, a bump, and I was like, what?
But it was convincing because I was like, oh my God, like, you know, you're getting.
I'm like, cry for, because I'm one of those people, I just had to experience that kind of emotion.
But that was the only scene where you had to experience the real thing.
I'm just
kidding. I'm just saying that scene was hot. I'm just checking on you.
Yes.
I'm just checking on you, just making sure. But I mean, honestly, anybody out there that has cable, pay-per-view, or can go out there and buy this movie. I mean, this movie is great.
Thank
so let everybody
you.
Know where they can see
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I mean, you can obviously get it, you know, through the Netflix, iTunes, Amazon, Walmart, and it's on Cinemax, I think, till April, actually. So from March till the end of April. So, and it's
I endorse it. I loved El Gringo. You guys know my
Thank
movie
you.
Reviews. If you want to see a hot badass chick and a hot badass dude with a lot of action, this movie is right up your alley. It's very all along Desperado, a la Desperado.
Yeah, it's just fun, and just the way they shot it was very cool.
And if you guys call in, we can do a giveaway. Last week, we were trying to do that, and our lines were down, but you can give us a call at 323-247-7443. Again, that's 323-247-7443. And as we go along through the next 20 minutes of our show, anybody that calls in will be able to give that away to them. What else are you working on now in the future?
Actually, I came back from Puerto Rico. I mean, I shot a few
other my country!
Films, yeah, the Boricuas.
Boricuas.
The tostones, there the mofongo. And I was like, oh my God, I'm going to gain so much weight.
Did you eat my country's
I
food?
I did, you know, because they put mofongo with everything.
Yeah, mofongo's with everything.
I was like, but you know what's weird? My
family doesn't so really, good. I mean, they make mofongo, but only on special occasions. More like rice and beans and pateles and totones, yeah, things like that.
But you know what I went to go find? I was like, because it was December, the holidays, so I was like, I want to see some coquito from Puerto Rico.
Oh, yeah.
And it was delicious.
The crazy thing about my family, they make it all year long.
Yeah,
they don't
well,
care.
We call it rompope.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is it the same ingredients,
same
though?
Ingredients, the three different milks, right. The coconut milk and everything, and the rum,
but we
of course.
Use the Puerto Rican, yeah, rum.
But the place I went to, they use like a marshmallow into the mix, into the drink.
Oh, that was
Puerto Rico.
A fancy place. We don't do that.
Yeah, it was muy fancy.
In the middle of the island, there's no marshmallows. My family's from Ponce, so we're like in the middle.
Oh, with the lions.
So, yeah.
I went there.
We're in, but we didn't see any lions. Not
no,
where
no,
I'm
no,
from.
The fake ones. The fake ones, but they're all painted like murals.
Yeah. My family's from Puerto Rico, so like, what's crazy is like, they're literally like, I always tell, my grandma was alive because she passed. I'm like, you're like from El Campo, like you don't. Did you go to the beach when you grew up? Like, I would ask all these questions.
Yeah.
She's like, I lived on a farm, and your mom, my mom's a twin with my uncle.
Oh, my God.
They were born in a barn, and I didn't even know I was having twins. I'm like, okay, so you didn't go to the beach.
Wow. But you know what? I did check out the Luminescence Bay, where these, like, it's a kind of, what is it? They
the microorganisms.
The yes.
You have a science degree.
I know, and come I couldn't think about it.
I was ESL, and I don't have anything. No, I'm kidding. But no, you have these microorganisms.
And then you have to swish it
yes.
around in the dark.
But this is what happened to me.
Super dark.
I did it because my cousin got married in Puerto Rico a few years ago.
Yeah.
And he got married at El Conquistador.
Oh, my God, yes.
It's romantic and
the
beautiful.
Most gorgeous.
Oh, it's gorgeous, right? But I went with a friend, and we went to go party, so I stayed at El San Juan Hotel. And I thought it would be smart to rent a car, which don't drive in Puerto Rico ever.
Oh, I drove.
And I hated it.
Yeah.
I drove Puerto Rico. I love you guys in my country, but you guys can't drive for crap. So I drove all the way to El Conquistador. So my cousin's like, stay the night. We're going to do the whole microorganism
thing. Yeah, and the canoes and the kayak.
I don't know how to swim. I'm the only Puerto Rican that doesn't know in the world
really?
How to swim. No. My family's from the middle of the island. They didn't
wow.
even see the water.
I mean, you have water.
I know. It doesn't make sense, but I don't know how to swim. And I'm kind of scared of the water because I don't
maybe
know how to swim.
Maybe someone will want to show you how.
Everyone's tried to, but I always kind of no. like, no, it's, no. I like to be in control so it doesn't work out for me. And the water, I just can't, no.
So jacuzzi's for you.
That's it. Not even that. I just don't like water. Just to take a bath, shower. But, no, so, you know, I did this because my cousin had a week-long marriage. Like, it was like a
celebration area.
Yeah, it was like a destination wedding thing. So he's like, you got to come out to do this with me, all my friends or my cousin. I'm like, okay, fine. I was scared of those things. They
really?
Jumped in the water and they're like floating with them and doing the whole thing.
It is so amazing.
I was wearing a life vest.
They do put life vests. And I was like, you know, I'm like, there's nothing here. And then it got super dark.
No,
and I was
it's
like,
beautiful.
Yeah,
but then I started thinking like they're on me and I got all freaked out.
Like slime.
Yeah. Like the microorganisms and are on my body. And now I'm like it freaked me out.
Really?
So that beautiful experience I did not have.
Wow.
That's the moral of the story.
And it's one of the only, I think, 6-7 places in the world. And two of them
and
are in Puerto Rico.
And we experienced that.
Wow.
See how destiny works out?
Yeah,
just kidding.
There we go.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
but wait, back to, I was there because I was shooting a film.
Tell me, that's the most important thing.
Go.
We're plugging something. Go,
there
go.
We go. Actually, it was called In the Blood and with the badass Gina Carano.
Oh, I love her.
Haywire.
The MMA girl.
Yeah. And
she's super hot.
She's amazing. Yeah.
Did you guys work out together?
No, we did not.
Damn.
I know. I think her.
She's like jacked up.
Yeah, she's intensely.
But
like,
is she
strong.
Still like MMAing or she's. An actress.
I think right now just actress. Like she was coming off Fast and the Furious 6.
Oh, wow.
So I think they were shooting in England or something, and then she came straight into In the Blood and with Count Gigante from Twilight.
I love him.
And yeah, he
played the first bad guy that got killed.
Yes.
And he's super hot.
He's in great shape, and you'll see that in the film too, of course.
Oh, wow. So what's your role in this film?
I play the nurse, and I can't say too much because you don't know if I'm part of the conspiracy. Basically, they go on a honeymoon to this beautiful, gorgeous island.
So Cam and Gina are together.
Cam and Gina are husband and wife, and they get married, and they go on a honeymoon. Yeah.
All these hot people in these movies.
So you'll go watch it.
I am. Right?
And then they go zip lining because one of the biggest zip lining places is right there in Puerto Rico.
I didn't know that. I need to go.
Yeah.
I ziplined in Cancun, but that was about it.
I didn't get to do it, but I wanted to.
I love it. And I'm afraid of heights.
Yeah, me too. Just talking about my hands are sweating.
You need to do it. It's amazing. It's an amazing experience. So go ahead. They're ziplining.
Yeah, they're ziplining. He falls, and then you don't know. You know, he gets taken in the ambulance, and you don't know he's not anywhere. He's not to be found anywhere. So she has to go find him. His family thinks, you know, she's after his money kind of thing. And so
it's like this whole
kind of like a Taken action. She kicks ass. I mean, you see
so
all
these
guys.
So she's like, she's the action. Instead of a lead, a male, it's her being the woman going out there and getting her man.
Exactly.
Wow, that's kind of cool.
Which is rare. And yeah.
Not in my world. Elite. I'm just kidding.
But I know what you mean. Every day.
I know what you mean. So she goes out there and she plays like the Vin Diesel role.
Exactly.
Of like getting her dude and saving him.
Definitely.
I like that.
Yeah. Danny Trejo.
Oh, I love him.
Yeah. Machete.
You guys have some, you work with some amazing actors.
Yeah. Mauri Nolasco, another Boricua.
That's great. Yeah. So when is that coming out?
Hopefully the end of this year or early next year.
And is that going to be a full on feature?
Yeah.
Or
full on feature.
That's awesome.
So that's going to be like something to definitely look forward to.
So you're busy. I mean, you're like, what other, besides that, and that one you already filmed, what are you in the works and now that you're working on now?
Yeah, well, actually, I have one of my films, Sorority Party Massacre, coming out on
Stars. Sounds like my kind of movie.
I play a sorority girl / dominatrix.
What the? Okay. What are your parents thinking about these roles?
You know, they haven't seen the trailer to that one, you know? I'll just kind of.
But is it like sexy, hot, like crazy?
It's fun and sexy. It's, you know, a bunch of girls and, you know, and there's a murderer in the cabin and,
Okay, so who stars in this movie with you?
Eve Morrow, who's a scream queen, and also Leslie Easterbrook from Police Academy. So it's kind of like a comedy horror.
Right, right.
And
well, I mean, they have like that movie Spring Breakers that's out. And,
I haven't
like, all
seen that.
I've heard, but I mean, there's all these, any movie with sorority girls and a murder is going to do well.
It's going to be fun. Yeah. There's going to be interest worldwide, I think, for something like that.
All right. We have a caller on the line. Oh, we're going to take this caller and see what they have to say.
All right.
Caller, you're on the Romy and Rose Show with our special guest, Yvette Yates. How are you today?
Hey, what's up? It's Gina. How's everybody going? What's going on?
Hey, how are you? Where are you calling from?
Orange County.
Hey, how are you? Do you have any... Do you have any
Newport?
You're so far away. You're right off the 405. Do you have any questions for Yvette at this time?
Wait, from last night?
No.
I thought it was from last night.
I can barely hear all you guys. I swear to God, I'm so sorry.
That's typical, you guys. I'm sorry. You all know my reputation. No, do you have a question for Yvette, our special guest today?
Hi.
I have a question, but what's going on? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You have an amazing voice. Oh, my God.
Oh, thank you.
She actually does. I like it. But what we're going to do is, since you called in, we're going to put you on hold, and we're going to get your information because you're going to end up winning one of our – well, you just won one of our giveaways. We have some nice stuff here that we're giving away. We're giving away posters. What did you bring? What do we have? And your headshot.
Oh, I know. We have the headshots. We have the After Dark Films posters and the El Gringo DVD.
So as you guys call, I know our phone lines are kind of wacky sometimes, but give us a call at 323-247-7443. Even after the show, we'll take your name and number down, and we'll send you guys some cool stuff that Yvette brought along for us today. All right, so we're going to continue our show. We're not taking any breaks because we're flowing like a... I don't know what flows, but we're flowing. I didn't want to get into that, but...
I was like,
I'm like, okay, so I love Justin Timberlake. I don't know how you feel about him.
I do. I think he's charming. I love him.
And he's one of my favorite guys in the world, but he kind of pissed me off this week. I'm going to tell you why. He did a MySpace interview about... Because he's plugging his, you know, record suit and tie. Which I happen to love. I've heard it. I love it. But he was talking about his Coachella experience, and they asked him about Coachella and how he felt about it. And he openly said, I've been to Coachella many times on many different substances. I've been to Coachella and I don't really remember a lot, and I'll leave it at that. And he talked about openly, you know, doing drugs, which, I mean, Justin's really well known, you know, and he's kind of like so that respected. Squeaky, clean image. And he talked about like what he did and what was out there and kind of put it out there about his drug use. And I don't know how I feel about that.
Yeah, I don't see why. I don't understand what the purpose of that would be. Doesn't he?
I don't know if he's trying to like seem like he's cool, which he doesn't need to be. He's Justin Timberlake.
Yeah.
Or if he was just trying to like, it was MySpace.
Just and being honest and kind of.
It's hard to resonate. But he also talked about part of his new 2020 experience, the suit and tie, you know, album that he'd made. About how some of those were done, some of it was written under the influence. And he wouldn't say of what.
Wow.
That kind of surprised me. I don't know.
It is just because you see right now lately the whole Justin Bieber thing, you know, and kind of being almost and MIA about things. And, you know, just another artist as well. And it's just, you know, I don't know. I think there is a responsibility.
Yeah, you know, I think there is. I mean, you know, for him being on the mega superstardom that he's at, we have a caller. We want to hear what the caller has to say. Caller, you're on the line with Rose and Yvette Yates. Where are you calling from? How are you?
I'm calling from Altaloma.
Hey, how are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Great. God. So what do you think about our Justin Timberlake situation?
Justin Timberlake or Justin Bieber?
Both of them. Well, our Justin Timberlake...
They're kind of tied.
Justin Timberlake recently came out on MySpace saying that, you know, he openly used drugs at Coachella and he was a little under the influence during his Coachella experience. And some of his record, you know, making was also, you know, under the substance. And with the Justin Bieber situation, like, how do you feel about Justin Timberlake being such a big iconic star and being older, kind of openly, you know, blaseing like it's no big deal?
Well, I don't particularly care for drug use, but if he cleans up his act, that's okay. Bieber's a douchebag.
I actually am kind of agreeing with you on that, even though I love him to death. I love his music.
If he picks up his act, he'll be okay.
Do you have any questions for our special guest today?
Yvette?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Well, I watched your movie, El Gringo.
Awesome!
No! Oh, my God. You're
What'd
amazing.
You think?
Well, I also saw you at the Battleship premiere.
Oh, yay! Really?
So what'd you think of the movie?
I love how we kick ass.
I love that.
You did kick ass in the movie.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to put you on hold since you watched the movie, and you're going to win a couple of our prizes, and we're going to put you on hold, get your information, and that way you can get a poster, a headshot. And we have another caller. Wow, your phones are blowing up. Caller, you're on the line on the Romy and Rose Show with our special guest, Yvette Yates.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. Who are you and where are you calling from?
My name is Seabass, and I'm calling from L.A.
Hey, how are you? So do you have any questions for our beautiful guest, Yvette Yates?
No, I kind of wanted to comment on the Justin Timberlake.
All right, do it. Nice. Go for it.
Well, I think that it's, like, better that he's being honest about it. I mean, obviously, he's a superstar, but he's kind of just proving that you don't have to be sober to be wonderful at what you do.
Or you don't have to be perfect, right? or you don't have to be perfect, because he's not perfect. And he's had a pretty squeaky clean image, and he's almost 30, so.
But I guess that I think he's always, like, been out about being a stoner, even, like, right when he left NSYNC and stuff. So, like,
he's a stoner? I didn't even know that.
I don't remember that.
I didn't know him to be a stoner.
Yeah, like, when he got punked and stuff, it was all, like, during that time.
Oh, yeah, I remember him getting punked, and he cried. When he got punked on Ashton Kutcher's show.
No.
They played, like, the IRS came and took all his stuff. And his mom wasn't on it. His manager, everyone was on it. And when he started crying,
it was really good.
When he started crying was when they said they took his dogs, because they used the money that his money was purchased with, like, you know, IRS money with his dogs. And he, like, literally sat on the curb and was, like, about to cry. So you're telling me he was high? He wasn't really sad. He was high.
Does he admit it? No.
I think that, like, yeah, he definitely admitted it, but not. I don't know if that for that taping. I just mean in general, he was. Just out about smoking weed.
I think now that I'm talking to you, you're changing my opinion about the situation, because I wasn't really happy about it. But given the fact that he's been around since he was 15, 14 years old, he's never really gotten into trouble or had any scandalous situation with the exception of Britney Spears.
And which is maybe her.
Right. Yeah. I mean, he's been a pretty good dude this whole entire time and a positive role model. But it was just kind of weird, like, wow, so late in the game, you're coming out with, yo, I got messed up at Coachella.
Yeah, it was weird. It's one of those, yeah.
But we're talking about it, and he does need some press.
I think it's just the media being late on reporting about it.
Okay, so we're gonna believe you on that. We're gonna put you on hold because you're also getting one of our wonderful posters as well from Yvette and from her movie All Gringo and a headshot. So hang tight so we can get your name and number down and take care of that as well. Before we wrap, I want to ask you some questions. Okay, so there's a lot of things going on right now in the media. Okay. One of the things are a lot of reality stars, and you're an actress. And I want to know how you feel about reality stars transitioning into film. Now, to me, if you're someone like Jennifer Hudson, who was naturally a performer and naturally an actor and is considered a reality star because she was on American Idol, which to me, that's different.
It's different to me.
But there, news broke that JWoww from Jersey Shore is now getting a reoccurring role on One Life to Live.
Wow.
I know.
Wow.
And, I mean, I'm a regular person who was on a reality show. And, I mean, I don't want to be an actor. And if someone wanted me to do a movie thing, I would feel really weird about it because that's not my thing.
I just think there's this awesome YouTube video. I don't know if you've seen it with Gary Oldman, who is an amazing actor.
I love him.
And he does this whole thing about athletes trying to be, you know, actors. And he's like, it's just a really funny
I have to YouTube that.
Yeah, it's he jokes about it, but and he does this whole monologue. And it's just, you know, it's kind of one of those things like, you know, it's. When it's your craft, you take it really serious, you know?
Yeah,
like an athlete, you know, fine-tuning his craft.
I mean, like,
I do
real estate, so if someone were to, like, just come off the street and say, you know, this is what I want to do or talk about it and I have the expertise, I have 13 years of experience, I'd be pissed.
Yeah, so it's one of those things that you're like, okay. But, I mean, if they're serious about it and they really want to do it, but if it's just kind of like...
There's certain actors, like, I made a list of a few of them that have been really successful, like NeNe Leakes from The Housewives of Atlanta.
Oh, that's right. She's on Glee or something,
she's
right?
She's not only on Glee, but she's now, you know, one of the stars of The New Normal. And she's doing movies and she's doing all this stuff.
Yeah.
And also, there's this one girl from The Real World, Jamie Chung, who was on Hangover 2. And I just recently saw her on some other movie. But she's also getting a bunch of roles. So, as an actor, I mean, how do you... I mean, is that like...
It's kind of a fine line because I'm not... There's some reality shows I'm just like, oh, I'm not a fan, you know, because they take away
air
time.
Were you a fan of mine?
Of course. I'm kidding.
No, you weren't. Our show is crazy. I wasn't a fan of our show. I'm still not. I got a bad rap on that damn show. No, I'm kidding.
You're like, I'll Instagram about it later.
Yeah, Instagram. I'll Instagram a picture of me with a halo around my head and what I'm really about.
But it is, it's another thing where you're just like, you know, as an actor, you're just like, wow, the reality shows had taken away time from, you know, like from actual shows, scripted shows, because it's, you know, it's cost efficient. And
it was very cheap. I wasn't, but the show was. I was very expensive.
Nice.
I'm kidding. So given that, you know, let everybody know where they can find you and where they can follow you and anything else that you want to let our audience know where she's going to come back. Don't think she's gone forever. She's our friend.
I will be back.
We're going to have her back as her projects progress. And as she does other things, she's going to be coming back and plugging her stuff and telling us about where she's going to be at. But tell them where they can find you, and you're getting an Instagram too.
Nice. Yes. So I am on Instagram, Twitter, and that I'm under Yvette Yates. So that's Y-V as in Victor, E-T-T-E-Y-A-T-E-S. And so that's my name, Yvette Yates. And then on Facebook, I'm actually under Actress Yvette Yates or Yvette Yates Official. And I'm working on my website. I'm still kind of figuring out if I should.
You got to get it together. People are going to want to follow you, want to know what's going on. You have all these amazing roles coming out. You're working with big actors.
I am. I'm blessed.
I'm excited
and grateful
for you.
And I thank you so much for you having me here and Romi and
we're gonna have
everyone
you back.
Here. Thank you. And
I want to wish
out there.
My amazing co-star, best friend, love of my life, sometimes when she doesn't get on my nerves, Romi Ray, please, please, please get better. Love you to death.
Yes.
She will be here next week. I will not be here next week, though.
Because
I'm going to be on Fuego at Dinah Shore in Palm Springs. It's
Must
Palm Springs. And it's like a big spring break for the people of my kind.
And
we're talking about thousands and thousands and thousands of women. And I'm hosting the weekend there with some other friends. And we're going to be out there. So Romy's going to have a special guest, which I believe may be Dusty. And I hope it is. So her and her husband are going to be here taking over the show next week.
Wow. I was actually curious. I was like, what is she going to wear?
Who, Romi?
Yeah, I was like, what is she going to wear?
She's probably going to wear a fur coat, something crazy. Who
yeah,
knows?
Yeah, exactly.
But real quick, before we go, I already wish Romi, you'll be all right. I know you'll be fine. My friend, Becky Soriano, sent me these wine glasses. And I want to give her a quick shout out. But anybody that wants to buy these can go to winemecompany@gmail.com. She hand makes these. They're beautiful. And I wanted to support her. And
She hand
paints them. Everything. Everything's done. Look at this craftsmanship.
I feel like it glows in the dark.
Isn't it beautiful? But she also does them custom. Like, you know, for marriage equality.
Oh, yeah.
She did some equality ones for people out there. So.
Oh, that's perfect. If you want timing right now.
Like, I would want one of you, a portrait of you from El Gringo on here.
I love that. From the bar scene. Or
yeah.
No.
Yeah. No, from that scene where you were like helping him. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm like, okay. I'm like, I can fix anything with the brown panties. Well, you'll have
I do want to personally thank you for being such a sport, because you didn't know you were going to co-host
today. I did not. But I'm having such a blast.
I kind of trapped you into this, and you like killed it. You did an amazing job.
Thank you. I was like, all right, let's go.
I hope you had fun, and we want to have you back.
Of course.
Thank you, everyone, all 300,000 of you for tuning in. Please tune in next week. Romy's going to be back here, hopefully with Dusty. Someone's covering me, because I'm going to be in Palm Springs with my fuego on. Everyone, love you guys so much. Please follow Yvette Yates and support her. We love you. We are out.
Bye. When I see you bounce, hold your hands, get your girls, it stay chef. Barely caught a glimpse of you and your friends giggling to the door with a women's restaurant. Y'all sound like vacuum shit. Y'all sound like Hoover, sounding like you. Come up in the bathroom, extra energized, ready for the work. You wanna fuck on me? You wanna fuck on me?
Get high, y'all. This is the fucking high song. Just roll up a dark brown backwood and do this. Roll up the haze, get blown, get stoned. My backwoods got the lady saying, put the purple in the air. Yeah, yeah, we getting money in. Come on. We roll splits to the pit. Fat shit, OG Kush, cat piss. Roll that shit. Roll something, smoke something, bring your 50s quickly. We got that sticky icky. From back out of the smoke, eyes low, I'm blacking out of my dope. Hydro pass.
Reality Radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. You're tuned in to LA Talk Live, where we're more than just talk.
Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple nonstop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.
Yo, what's the deal? Medical Herbs for You, located at